Friends, myself, Dr. Admurthy Namdev Bhagwan, working as a assistant professor at Raith Shikshan Sansthas, Anna Sahib Aute College, Mancha. Today, we are going to study life cycle of Bacteriospermum, class TYBSC, paper Cryptogamic Botany, unit Algae, subunit life cycle of Bacteriospermum. In this life cycle, points are systematic position, occurrence, thallus structure, and reproduction. These are the points in our study. Then we study first point, systematic position. Systematic position, or it is also called as taxonomic position or classification. In a systematic position, division, class, subclass, order, family, and genus. Here, these Bacteriospermum, they are included in division Algae. Division Algae, then class Rhodophyceae, then subclass Noridae, then order Nemeleonates, family Bacteriospermaceae, and genus Bacteriospermum. Here, characters. Algae, you know that algae are the simple plants. There is presence of chlorophyll pigments. In algae, cell wall is made of a cellulose. Then, another one of the character of the algae is the stored or reserve of food material is in the form of starch. Then, class Rhodophyceae. In class Rhodophyceae, there is presence of red pigment and there is the stored or reserve food material in the form of Floridian starch. Then, subclass Floridae. In subclass Floridae, the thallus structure, they are filamentous. Then order Nemeleonates. Nemeleonates. Character of the order Nemeleonates is that thallus is filamentous and it may be uni or multi-axial. Then family Bacteriospermaceae and genus Bacteriospermum. Bacteriospermaceae, most of the members of the Bacteriospermaceae, they are found in fresh water. They are uniaxial and life cycle is haplobiontic. These are the classification or systematic position of the Bacteriospermum. In short, Bacteriospermum, they are included in division Algae, class Rhodophyceae, subclass Floridae, then order Nemeleonates, and then family Bacteriospermaceae and genus Bacteriospermum. Then next point, occurrence. This algae Bacteriospermum, it occurs in aquatic condition. Aquatic condition means in water, they are found in especially fresh water. Fresh water. In the fresh water, Bacteriospermum, they are attached to the stones in slow moving water. They are found in streams. They are also found in the rivers. Bacteriospermum is also found near the lake or margin of the lake. In short, Bacteriospermum is found in aquatic condition, means in water. Then, next point, thallus structure. This is the thallus structure of the Bacteriospermum. Thallus structure is microscopic, then multicellular and filamentous. Then these filaments, they are branched. Adult thallus. When thallus is adult, mature, adult, at that time thallus, it looks like a chains of beads. It looks like chains of beads. Chains of beads means in Marathi it is called as maleche mani. Then that thallus, Batrachospermum is mucilage genus. In the this is the thallus structure of the Batrachospermum. It shows main axis. On that main axis, there are two types of branches. That is the branches of limited growth and branches of unlimited growth. In this way, in thallus of the Batrachospermum, there are two types of branches. One is the branches of unlimited growth, and second is the branches of unlimited growth. Branches of unlimited growth means their growth is continuous. Therefore, they are called as unlimited growth. These are the growth is continuous. Therefore, they are called as unlimited growth. Another one is the branches of limited growth. Branches of limited growth. Their growth is stopped. That branches are called as branches of limited growth. Then next point is the reproduction. Reproduction means production of new individual. In Batrachospermum, reproduction takes place by vegetative, asexual and sexual method. First, vegetative method. In vegetative method, it takes place by fragmentation. Fragmentation is the simple method. In this method, what happened? That thallus or thallus plant body, it breaks into a small pieces or into small fragments. Then each piece or each fragments, they use rise to a new individual. That is called as vegetative reproduction by fragmentation. Then second type is the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is takes place by monospores, and these monospores, they are developed on the Chondrichia stage, and these monospores, they are haploid, and they separate from the Chondrichia stage, and each monospore, they gives rise to a new individual. That is called as asexual reproduction by monospores. The next type, next to the sexual reproduction, the next type is the sexual reproduction. In Batrachospermum, there is a male reproductive organ and female reproductive organ. Male reproductive organ is called as antheridia, and female reproductive organ is called as carpogonia. Antheridia, it produces spermatia, and carpogonia produces an egg. Then fertilization takes place in between the spermatia and egg. After fertilization, there is formation of zygote, and zygote is diploid. Then that zygote, meiosis takes place. Then it forms a gonioblast filament. That gonioblast filament, it develops into a carposporangia. Then in that carposporangia, carpospores are present. Then that carpospore, they germinate and form the Chondrichia stage, and that Chondrichia stage develop into a Batrachospermum. In this way, sexual reproduction takes place by male reproductive organ with the help of male reproductive organ antheridia, and female reproductive organ carpogonia. Then this is the life cycle or alternation of generation. Here Batrachospermum is a haploid plant. On that Batrachospermum, there is the production of the male reproductive organ and female reproductive organ. Male reproductive organ is called as antheridia, and female reproductive organ is called as carpogonia. Then next step, antheridia produces spermatia, and carpogonia produces an egg. Here spermatia, they are uninucleate and non-motile. Uninucleate and non-motile. Non-motile means flagella or cilia are absent. Then there is the process of fertilization. At the time of fertilization, what happens? That the nuclei of the spermatia and nuclei of the egg, they fuse together and form a zygote. In the life cycle of the Batrachospermum, zygote is diploid. Only zygote is diploid. Zygote is formed. Then in that zygote meiosis takes place. Meiosis, or it is also called as reduction division. Reduction division takes place and it forms a gonioblast filament. And that gonioblast filament is applied due to the meiosis. Then that gonioblast filament, it forms a carposporangia. And in that carposporangia, carpospores are present. And then that carpospore, they develops into a contractile stage. That contractile stage, it produces monosporangium. In that monosporangium, monospores are present. These monospores, they develops into a new individual. We studied already in asexual reproduction. That is, asexual reproduction takes place by monospores. Then this contractile stage, it develops into a new individual, that is a batrachosperm. In this way, this is the haploid stage and this is the diploid stage. These are the points in the life cycle of batrachosperm. That is the systematic position, occurrence, then thallus structure, and then reproduction. In this way, this is the life cycle of the batrachosperm. Thanks. On the next lecture, we will be studying life cycle of sargassum. Okay, thank you.